go for the plunge here on Journey to Atlantis, the classic food ride here at SeaWorld Orlando. Let's do it. Quaint little fishing village here in the south of Greece. As we're at the queue for Journey to Atlantis. This attraction used to have this very elaborate backstory about how Atlantis rose from the oceans, and apparently all of that's gone. I haven't ridden this ride in a very long time, so we're gonna see how it is now, but I've heard it's not great, so we're gonna find out. But yeah. I will say though, one complaint I have is you are now forced to store your bags and stuff in a locker. The locker system here is really lousy. I'll get into that in a second, but yeah. Anyway, hopefully the ride's decent.
We're hearing from the other vessels that the seas are rough down there, so hang on tight and prepare to get wet.
Thank you.
Atlantis, you head here to the gift shop and aquarium, because naturally there's a gift shop and an aquarium. So you got a lot of pretty standard SeaWorld merch. I wish there was something specific to Journey to Atlantis in here, because that would be cool. There's not though, but we can check out this aquarium over here and see what's in here. This is kind of cool. Over here we have no jellyfish, or at least we're supposed to. I don't see any at the moment. We have different kinds of fish. Constantly going in front of us. It looks fake. It's cool though. You might want to make this a screensaver. Stare into all the fish that are passing your way. Continue to stare in them. All the fish. Keep staring. You're not going to forget this sight anytime soon. All of the fish that are coming past your screen right now. And they're cool. Yeah. Anyway.
Is there a moon jellyfish?
Is there more of like a tropical tank? It's a blue tang. There's a yellow tank, clownfish. All kinds of cool stuff. So this is a nice little tropical display of different fish. There's yellow tang, there's clownfish. That's a neat. It's Nemo and Dory. That's a different park though. That's cool. Wow. And then over here, here where the moon jellyfish are. This is another kind of like screensaver thing, because they don't look real, but they are. They're just sitting there right in front of you. Jellyfish are really bizarre creatures. Really bizarre.
It's so soothing to look at. It's beautiful. Stare into the jellyfish. They will stare into your soul. No, I'm not going to get into that.
Anyway, that was the aquarium portion, and that's going to do it for this complete experience, little cam, of Journey to Atlantis. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you next time on Thrill Seekers.
All right, so I just got off of Journey to Atlantis, and I have to say, I'm really disappointed. This ride used to be one of my all-time favorites in Orlando. It had great theming. The ride itself is fun. I mean, it's the only ride that I know of that's kind of a combination of flume and coaster that's been done this way, at least that I've ridden. And it used to be absolutely phenomenal. It was one of the marquee attractions that was not at a Disney park. And over the years, it just kept decaying and decaying. Effects broke. They never fixed them. And the state it's in now is just horrendous. I mean, they've removed all story elements. There's effects that are there. They're just sitting there. They aren't being used. The soundtrack doesn't blend with the ride at all. It's just bizarre. I know supposedly the plan was they were going to try to combine the story of Journey to Atlantis with the story of Kraken VR, which we know how that turned out. Kraken VR, of course, is gone, removed after less than a year. So I don't know where that leaves Atlantis, whether they're going to just leave it in this terrible state or if they're going to try to give it some kind of story again, because I missed the story elements. It was great back in the day, but not so much anymore. So that's my review. I hate to say it, but I mean, it's a ride that definitely needs some work. So in addition to completely getting rid of Wild Arctic SeaWorld, you need to do some work on Atlantis, because it needs a story again. So yeah, that's my review, and that's it for our complete experience thrill cam of Journey to Atlantis here at SeaWorld Orlando. See you next time.